Hey, Chris here with WholeApple and WholeApple TV again. Thanks for joining us. Today we're doing a review of the iPhone 4. No, I'm kidding. That's been done about a billion times. I've got a little bit ahead of myself on the unboxings here, and I wound up unboxing a couple of these already. Actually, only one, but I unboxed them out of the box, and we're going to take a look at them now. One is the HardCandy BubbleSlider, which I really, really like. This is a great little iPhone case. As you can see, it's nice and shiny and metallic. Gives a lot of attention to you for those people who might want to steal your iPhone. But no, all kidding aside, it's really great. It's got a nice grip to it. It doesn't slide or slip or anything. It's got a nice little metal edge, but it doesn't affect going to the edge of your iPhone. So when you turn it on and you want to, for example, you want to slide icons around, if you want to hold an icon and, let's get an icon going. You want to make them wiggle and move them from screen to screen. Some of the other cases, you would have a problem with that. And this is really well designed. The bezel on this is just beautiful so that it doesn't actually get in your way when you're trying to use the phone in the entirety of its screen. So that's really nice. I like that a lot. It's got a recessed area for your power button here, as you can see, and your headphone jack, of course. It's got a little recessed area for your buttons. They're a little bit harder to get to, but not much. The biggest issue I have with this case is the lack of ability to get to the mute button, which isn't really that bad. If you just have any kind of fingernail whatsoever, which I do, thank God, you can easily, you know, turn that on and off. It just, you know, isn't quite as simple, which might actually be a good thing for some people. But, you know, that is definitely a little more recessed. And you're going to have an issue if you don't have any fingernails or if you have really, really huge fingers. But otherwise, it's fine. It's a great design. It feels nice and sturdy. It doesn't feel like it's going to break or anything like some of the other, you know, cheaper cases do. And the way you put it on and take it off is really nice. It's got a little connection right here that has not come apart yet as we speak. It has not come apart at all on me. And like I said, I've been using this for about a week. And it's great. So the black piece here connects underneath to this top piece, and it's a very solid fit. It's very, very well made, just typical of HardCandy stuff. I haven't found one of their products yet that has been cheap or any kind of, you know, it wouldn't have disappointed me, you know, at all had I bought them full retail. So slide the iPhone out here, and you can see it's got a bit of a rubbery kind of grip to the inside to protect your iPhone's backing from any scratching, but this is a very flat plastic. So this case is very nice. I highly recommend it. It's very well made. It feels sturdy. It gives your iPhone some decent protection. And even if you were to drop this, you know, flat on its face with the iPhone inside of it, unless you hit it, you know, hit the screen with on a corner of something, if you drop this flat on the ground, the screen wouldn't actually touch anything because of this bezel. So that's really nice. So I like this case a lot. This is the HardCandy HardCandy BubbleSlider. And it's about $29.95, I think. We'll have the price up on screen for you down there. And it's something I definitely recommend. I highly recommend it. Thank you for sending this for review. Is the Gumdrop, which is another brand of their case, another style of the HardCandy line of case. This is the Surf Slider. This is the Gumdrop Surf Slider for iPhone 4. And I have a feeling it's going to be a little bit more of a rubbery kind of a silicone type feel. So we'll just get the tape off here. And we'll take a look at this. And what do we got? No, it's a hard plastic case as well. So this is nice. It's basically the same concept as the bubble slider that we have here, just in a blue translucent material. As you can see, it's got some definite translucency to it. So we've got that. And you can see right here, a little surfer picture. If you're a surfer, I guess that'll help you make your decision. So we've got this. Operates on the same principle. Looks a little bit different than the other one, but we'll go ahead and try this on our iPhone right now. See how this fits. And it is kind of a tight fit when you first get these things on, definitely, which is a good thing. You want them to be tight and you want them to be solid. So that's nice. Put this on right here and it just kind of snaps on right there. And there we go. We have the Surf Slider. I keep on wanting to get these names mixed up here. It is the Surf Slider for iPhone 4. So you can see that because of the translucent nature of the plastic, you can actually see the Apple logo below the surface. So that's nice. Especially if you're an Apple fanboy, like I guess I am. When you have a company called WholeApple, I guess you better be. But this is very nice. It's got a nice feel to it. I'm a little concerned for myself. Not that I've ever dropped an iPhone, actually. I don't think I have. In fact, I know I haven't. But it doesn't have quite the grip that the Bubble Slider does. This really has a nice knobby feel to it because of these divots. And it's also a little bit more of a grippy type plastic. This has a matte finish, if you can see this finish here. It's kind of hard to tell in the video. It's kind of got a matte kind of textured finish, but it isn't really that textured. It's very, very smooth, and it doesn't really necessarily give you any kind of a grip. So, you know, you'll want to be careful with it, but it's pretty. I like it, and it operates on the same principle as this, very solidly made. So both these cases are very nice. I think that, you can't go wrong with either of these cases. It's just a matter of personal preference. I like the translucency on this. And I guess I could get used to the feel of it, and I'll try it out for a couple days, and we'll let you know our final results in the review.